Hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to reverse a string by using recursion in C++. So if you're coming from a different language background like Java, C or Python, you can even watch this video because the core logic is going to be the same thing because functions and recursion concept and logic remains the same. So let's get started. So I will just declare a function, okay? So at the end, we are just going to return a string. So it's going to be string, okay? String check, I will name it as check. And we are going to pass the string itself recursively. So it's going to be string of, let's say, str, okay? Let str be our string and our base case. So as you can know, every recursion will have a terminating or base case. So here it's so simple. If str.size, which gives the length of the string, equal to 0, we will just return empty string, okay? Empty string, that's it. And our recursive case, okay, it's going to be return check, okay, check off. Here it's going to be str dot sub str of 1 comma str dot size, okay, and we are going to add this with plus str of 0. So first I will run this code and show you, then I will just explain this code with the help of a demo, okay? So here in this main function, I'm just going to put C out check, I'll just put R, okay, something short word. So it's, we need to get the output as E R A, okay? So I'll just execute this code now. So as you can see, we are getting error, and I will just also put hello, okay, and just show you this one also. So I'm getting the reversed way. So how it works is that I will open paint, okay? So let's take our condition as R, okay? R is easy to do because can't write more, I can't write properly. So here it's just a simple condition over here. We will just pass R over here, okay? I will change this also to R. Be fine. So you're just changing it to R, and we are passing R over here. String str is R, and it checks R dot size equal to 0. That is, condition is false because R size is 3. So this won't be getting returned, and here it will go over here and will check. What happens here is that I will write check C, okay, check of str dot sub str 1 comma size. So what the sub str 1 comma size does is that it generates a substring that removes the first character alone. So it considers all the characters from the first index, that is from R till the end. So we have only R E over here. It will just remove the 0th index. Okay. Suppose it's hello. In case of hello, we are passing hello means it will remove H and it will just be E L L O. So it basically just removes the first character. Okay. Simple. So we will be passing R E, and here it will be plus str of 0. Our str is R and str of 0 is A. So this is what happens in the first recursive call, okay? It will just be pushed in the recursion stack, okay? So this is doing the first recursive call. Now our str is re, okay? It's not r, it's now re. So because we have been changing it and we are again calling this str, yeah, okay, string str. So while getting passed, it will be passed as re. So now we will again check str dot size equal to 0. This is false because we have re, okay? It's 2, so this is false, and again it will be passed. So it will be now c of, here is the game changing part. We have to consider RE. Okay, we should not consider ARE because we have changed our str from RE, ARE to RE. Okay, so here it's going to be 1 comma str dot size. So it's going to be from, you know, we aren't having anything. We have because 1 is E. Okay, so it's only going to be E. So only E is going to be over here, and our plus str of 0. Str of 0 is here R, okay, to be really careful with that. And now what happens that during the next call, okay, our E gets pushed inside it, okay? So E, str is E, okay? So what happens here is that at the last, during the, it comes over here, its size is 1, so it does not return. And here is the main part, sub str of 1 comma str size. So this won't, this will be null basically, this will be 0, empty string, because we have only one element with the index value of 0. So there isn't any element from 1 to last one. So this is completely false. So what will happen is that it will be a empty string, C of empty string, will be str of 0 is only e. Okay, and now we have like completely eliminated our entire string. So an empty string will be passed during the next call, and this return function will be executed. So during the last call, we will be getting this empty string. Okay, so now we have just pushed all our recursive function calls into a stack. So now it will just get process are terminated from the top to bottom. Okay, because stack is first in last out. Okay, so or last in first out. So last in is this one. So this will return as e. Okay, this will return e. So this c of e will be replaced by e, and this will become er. Okay, and this c of re will be replaced by this er. So at the end, while coming out, it will be era, and that will be returned over in the output. So if I just run it now, I will be getting the output as era. So this is how it works for all the cases. Okay, for hello, it will be like for all also same process. It will just take. It will be like h and e and llo. Okay, you can guess like l and o, and in the last iteration it will be 0, and it will be like OLLE and OLLEH. Same thing, I think hello takes last time, so it's reduced to r. Okay, so this is how this entire process of recursion and reverse string works. I think nobody would do reverse string by using recursion, because using O of n, you can just use O of n like a for loop and just write it from back. There are also inbuilt functions also to perform reverse string. So that's it for this video. And I also run many tutorials in C, C++, Python, Blender, that is 3D animation, and Unity. So it will be really great if you could check other videos of my channel. Subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.